In today's video, we will learn how to vacuum the refrigerator system and charge refrigerant inside the refrigerator. Now let's weld all the points of the compressor, as we have installed a new compressor in the refrigerator. First of all, I will weld the discharge pipe. Now for checking your welding, you can use a mirror. Through this, you can see the backside of the pipe. And you will figure out whether you had welded it correctly or not. Now, I will fit and weld the charging line on this side of the compressor. Now I will install the filter with it. I will use and install this 15-gram filter made in Italy with the refrigerator's condenser. First of all, I am welding the capillary tube with the filter. Put your welding torch downward to let the filter get hot. Now the filter has warmed up. And our soldering has been completed in 20 to 30 seconds. Now, I have made a pipe ready for the liquid line of the refrigerator. I am welding that as well. Complete the welding process as fast as possible, through which your weld finishes nicely. See, this pipe has also been welded. The welding should take 20 to 30 seconds. Now, let's weld the liquid line which goes inside the filter. All the pipes welding should take less than 1 minute and should not exceed this time. As if you took more than 1 minute, the pipe can overheat, and your welding will be of no use. This is our last welding for the compressor. I am soldering the last pipe of the compressor, which is the suction line. Solder the pipes the same, quickly as possible. Do the soldering precisely, as no area of the pipe should be left from welding. See, now we have completed the soldering. Now I have set up the system for vacuuming the refrigerator. I've kept the vacuum pump over here. With the vacuum pump, I have installed the manifold gauge as well. And the other side of the gauge is installed with the charging line. So here, the system is ready to be vacuumed. Let me start the vacuum pump. First, I will open the nut of the manifold gauge so that the air can go out of the system easily. Now I am going to switch on the pump. As I started the vacuum pump, the gauge was going towards minus. The minus one is written on the indicator, as you can see. Now I will leave the system to vacuum for 15 to 20 minutes, and will still leave the system to vacuum after the needle goes to zero, through which the air inside will get burned. Whenever we vacuum any system, the air inside starts getting burned. As you can see here as well. Water was inside this system of refrigeration in this refrigerator. As you can see, smokes are coming out of the pump. This is water burning. We can easily figure it out, and it is also getting caught on the camera. It's good that it is burning the water inside. I will keep vacuuming it for a maximum of half an hour so that all the moisture inside could burn and come out of its refrigeration system. Now it's almost 20 minutes. The refrigeration system has been vacuumed. Let me show you. The vapors from the pump by the burning of moisture are also not coming out of the fridge. So the manifold gauge is also showing us that the system has been appropriately vacuumed, and the needle you can see is showing minus one on the gauge. First, we will close the gauge's valve so the connection between the system and the pump may break. Now I will switch off the pump. And this way, the vacuum of the refrigeration system has been completed. Now I will crack the system with gas and then start charging refrigerant. But before cracking the system, and filling the refrigerant in the refrigerator, we left the system for 20 minutes to know whether the leakage was in the fridge or not. The needle of the gauge is standing in the same position. If the needle on the gauge starts moving upwards, it means that the fridge has leakage or any other problem is present in the refrigerator. But if there is no such thing happening on the gauge, it means that the system is fine and ready for gas charging. Now, whenever we charge gas in any refrigerator, the gas is charged by weight in the fridge system, so you should have a proper scale for that purpose. Now I am placing the R134A refrigerant cylinder on the weight machine. I will install the red colored inlet pipe of the gauge with that gas cylinder. After attaching the pipe to the gas cylinder, open the valve of the gas cylinder. You can charge refrigerant in the refrigerator with two methods. The R134A refrigerant is charged in the form of gas. Therefore, the liquid form of the refrigerant should not be charged in the fridge, through which the compressor can get bad. The first method is when you charge the refrigerant slowly, you will add it in the form of gas. The second method is if you charge its full pressure one time by weight, then you will have to charge it in liquid. Then you will have to wait for half an hour for the gas inside the refrigerator to turn into vapors, and then you have to turn on the fridge. Now see, friends. This cylinder's face is upward so that the liquid will go inside the system, and I know it. So first, I will remove the air out from the pipe of the cylinder. I will now open this red pipe a little, and see the air has come out of the pipe. Now I will tighten the red pipe back again. And I will tighten it correctly to prevent any air from going inside the system. I will put the weight machine to zero by pressing the TR button. So see, the scale of the weight machine is showing zero. Now I will open the valve of the manifold gauge. And after opening the gauge valve, the refrigerant will be charged in liquid form. You can see the scale minus 44, minus 45, and so on. So we have to charge 210 grams of refrigerant in this refrigerator. So the refrigerant of 208 grams has been filled in the refrigerator according to the weight, which is the requirement of this fridge. Now I will leave the refrigerator for almost half or an hour, so that the refrigerant inside the fridge could turn liquid into vapors, and then I will start the refrigerator. Now you can see this compressor I have installed. It is a Panasonic company's compressor. And the compressor installed before this was of Danfoss. See, I have used the same relay. I have just rotated it and changed its position. This way, all the connections on the relay will be the same. And the compressor will work perfectly. Now enough time has passed, and I have installed electricity to it. And I will turn it on. The compressor has turned on, and I can hear the voice of the compressor running. You can see on the ampere meter that the system is consuming 1.8 amperes. And gradually the amperes will decrease. Now I will have to keep an eye on the gauge of what pressures it shows and check whether the back pressure is okay. To check this, we will have to wait. And keep checking it. Now see, the system is working perfectly. If you want to check how your refrigeration system works, use your hands. For this, you have to check the condenser pipe. When you touch its condenser, it should be warm, and when you go upwards, it should also be heated above. When we see the condenser pipe from downward on the left side, this is its liquid line, it should not be that cold nor too hot, then it means your refrigerator is perfectly working. But if the pipe is too cold, then it means the system is choked. And if it's too hot, then it means that the system has refrigerant in excess amount. We will have to take the excess gas out of the system. So this way you can check and have an idea whether the system is working fine after refrigerant charge or not. Now, let's talk about the final result, and we have got its final result. See, the compressor is consuming 1.2 amperes, which is a good thing. After this, if we see its return pipe, it is cold and the liquid should never come back in it. It should be cold slightly. If it is too cold or ice is on this pipe, then it means the refrigerator has excessive gas, as the return on this pipe should be vapors, not liquid, which help the compressor to cool down. After this, if we see the refrigerator final results, the freezer temperature is minus 21 degrees Celsius. And see, the sensor is inside the freezer box, which is showing us the temperature. Now let's talk what should be its back pressure and as well as its standing pressure. I have switch off the fridge right now. And let me tell you an important thing, that the back pressure and standing pressure of the refrigerator depends on the temperature and the amount of refrigerant charged in the refrigerator. If you had overcharged the refrigerant, the pressure and temperature both could be high. You must be aware of this if you want to measure both the pressures accurately. The amount of refrigerant I had charged is accurate and the pressures are also accurate. Now see, the temperature of the freezer is 29 degrees Celsius. Which means its standing pressure should be 100 pounds per square inch. Let me show you. See, it is showing 99 pounds per square inch on the gauge. The standing pressure depends on the temperature. As if the temperature would have been 30 degrees, then the pressure would be 100 pounds per square inch and so on. And when the temperature decreases, then the pressure will also go low. Now when we talk about the back pressure, it also depends on the amount of gas charge as well as temperature. As I have charged the refrigerant accurately, I have turned the fridge on again and the temperature is going to be minus 21 degrees. we should get a back pressure of 5 pounds per square inch, which is above zero. I hope you learned a lot from this video. So this was for today's video. I will catch you in the next one.